It is a cold winter's day in Atlanta today, and I need something to warm me up. You know, it seems ironic that one of the best beverages to warm one's soul is that blissful beverage cocoa, which comes from the tropics. But whoever thought of taking the seeds of the cocoa tree embedded deeply in its fruit and turning that into a delightful drink? That is what we are going to check out. Ted here. Journey with me, if you will, to 1500 BC, when the Olmecs began to develop the first advanced civilization in Mesoamerica, in the area we now call Veracruz. At this time, the climate and river basins of the area mirrored those of the Nile, the Indus, and the Yellow River valleys. Now, legend has it that an Olmec farmer saw a group of rats eating the seed pods of the cocoa tree and saw how it energized them. And evidently, he thought to himself, well, if it's good enough for them. As the beans were very bitter but enervating, anthropologists speculate that the Olmecs took to grinding the beans and mixing them in hot water with chilies and herbs. Though they did not understand the biochemistry behind it, the Olmecs found that cocoa was a highly effective anti-inflammatory, reduced blood pressure, improved brain functions, decreased depression, was an antibacterial, good for their teeth, and boosted their immune systems. And very quickly, the Olmecs moved to commercial production of cocoa, with cocoa being such an important crop that it was actually used as a form of currency. Christopher Columbus was the first European ever recorded to have seen cocoa beans in what we now call the country of Nicaragua. He saw them stored in a native canoe. It was the year 1502. Still, it wasn't until Cortez met with the Aztec emperor, Montezuma, who offered Cortez a drink of the beverage, that a European ever sampled that succulent sip. In 1528, Cortez brought back the first cocoa beans to the Spanish court, along with the equipment to make the beverage. The Spanish adapted the beverage by adding the newly affordable cane sugar, vanilla, some cinnamon, and other herbs like cloves to suit their tastes. And by 1585, Spain had developed a trade for cocoa beans with the New World, though they kept them to themselves, not allowing them to be exported to the rest of Europe. In fact, a group of English pirates around this time seized a Spanish galleon filled with cocoa beans. Not knowing what they were, the English actually burned them. But by the 17th century, the word had spread, and cocoa grew in popularity across the upper classes of Europe, so much so that Louis XIII actually toasted his new bride, Princess Anne, with a draft of cocoa in 1605. And by 1650, cocoa was a staple in England. By the time of World War I and World War II, both of those episodes, both the British government and the United States government believed cocoa to be so important that the 100% of the nation's cocoa supplies for each country was requisitioned for the military. So the next cup of cocoa you have, just remind yourself of the health benefits and the history. There's no reason to feel guilty. I hope that this has been fun and informative. For more fun videos, recipes, and travel tips, check out our website, historybytheplate.com. Oh, and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. It is fun and free. Happy cooking!